These are pictures of trees planted by Ecosia users around the world. But with more than 50 tree planting partners in all of these pictures, why aren't we showing you more before and after images, such as this, this, or this one? Welcome to Tree Update 30. If Ecosia has already planted more than 100 million trees, why don't we post before and after pictures every day? The short answer is, before and after images are great, but they're not always the best way to monitor tree planting progress. Together with our partners, our goal is to restore entire landscapes in a way in which they won't be deforested again. To do this, we need to approach each planting site as the unique natural landscape that it is. So while we of course gather before after pictures of the trees we plant, there's much more to restoring a landscape. For example, connecting our partners to one another so that we can share learnings, or building future projections of how the trees we plant could help contribute to helping communities build a better future in a changing climate. Okay, here we go. By now, Ecosia is working with more than 50 tree planting partners around the globe, and the number is steadily growing. These partners are spread across different continents. They operate in different time zones and climates. Some organizations are tiny, while others have been in the game for much longer. So the fastest way to keep in touch with them is through WhatsApp groups. I set up a group for each new tree planting partner, and this gives us, but also our partners, a quick and immediate way to update one another. Like the time when Lori from IPE, one of our partners in Brazil, spotted these jaguar paw prints on one of the sites where we plant trees. But I'm not just in contact with our partners to ask them for photos and information. We consider our partners part of the Ecosia tree planting team. If we are serious about restoring landscapes, we must understand the unique environmental context of each natural space we work in. And we can only do this with our partners on site. Planting trees might seem easy, but it really isn't if you're determined about planting the right type of tree in the right type of place, and also thinking about how to make sure that a standing, living tree is more beneficial to the community than cutting it down. This is a difficult balance to keep, and each community, each project takes a different approach to this, which is why it's important for us to create a space in which we can all learn from one another. We have regular calls with our partners. Sometimes they call us directly from the tree nurseries. Other times, we're going deeper into certain topics. For example, how to use Ecosia's monitoring app on the ground. We also use a new private Facebook group to share articles, updates, and news with each other. Having this shared space is really important. If you follow the news, you might have realized that tree planting has become very popular in the past few years and even months. Unfortunately, not all of this tree planting is being done diligently. As some journalists reported, many organizations are planting monocultures or planting invasive species. Much of the large-scale tree planting is done without taking into account the community or the fact that sometimes the best way to restore a landscape is by not planting trees at all, but simply letting them grow back. At Ecosia, we share learnings with our partners and give them the space to speak to each other too, so that we can continue planting trees, thinking of people, animals, and nature in general. Proof that our trees are being planted and that they do survive over time is of course the basis of our work. We actually told you about how we monitor your trees in episode 25, which you can watch again here. In that episode, we also showed you how our partners send us geotagged images of your growing trees and polygons of the sites where they are located, which serves as the basis for before and after pictures that we then post on our social channels. The thing is that the changes in pictures like that are somewhat obvious. For example, a barren landscape turns green. But other times, the changes in the landscape are less obvious to the eye, but still super important for the local ecosystem. And therefore, seeing the changes can require knowledge about how and where to look. Let me show you what I mean. Hello, Peter.
So we're talking about how can we see the trees growing? And in some cases, that's really, really obvious. I have an example here from one of our sites in Nicaragua. This is how it looked in 2006. And after the work of Fundación Dia, it now looks like this. The speed in which trees grow is really a function of temperature and rainfall. These are the two limiting factors. The higher the temperature and rainfall together, the faster they grow, like in the tropics, in the wet tropics. If one of the two goes down, there's less rainfall or temperature is lower, then it's a bit more tricky to see changes in the first years because the trees simply don't grow that fast. When you think about monitoring trees, your eyes are also your limiting factor, because you can of course see trees growing with your eyes, but actually there's much better ways to measure whether there's actually trees growing or whether there's more vegetation. And what is really important is that satellite imagery can also show infrared light. And if we combine the red light, which is absorbed by the leaves, and with the infrared light that is not absorbed with the trees, we can make an index. So the relation between the two tells you how the vegetation is developing over time. This is called the normalized differentiated vegetation index. The more leaves you have, the higher the index will go. And this is one of the tricks we're using in our monitoring platform for many sites where with the naked eye, we can't really very clearly see the change yet. We do see the NDVI going up. For example, here you see a graph that plots the NDVI, where you see that over time, every year the NDVI gets higher and higher and higher because the trees are growing. So this is an excellent way for us to monitor in the first years how the trees are growing and whether there's actually progression in vegetation. The older the sites get, of course, the more you already can see the changes. For example, I have a site here in Ghana where we work with Tree 8. And there, it's a relatively dry climate still, but already after some years, you actually start to see the change. And if you look at this very high resolution imagery here and you zoom in quite a lot, then you actually see there's many more trees growing today than there were before we started to work.
All right, thanks, Peter. So as you see, there's much more that goes into restoring landscapes than planting trees. And there's much more than a before and after image of a growing tree to show us that we're making good progress. I have actually prepared a couple of before after images for you at the end of the video. But before you jump off to that part of the video, let me show you something else that's really cool. This is Kevin from Wells for Zoe, one of our tree planting partners in Malawi.
This is, we're from Wells for Zoe and we're installing water wells and pumps in the central northern area of Malawi. And as you can see on this map, we spend quite a lot of time mapping all those pumps. And the idea was to bring this transparency that we've been doing since years for the pumps to the reforestation projects. Because what you can obviously not do is take a photo of each individual tree and map it out with GPS, and that's not gonna work. And so what we do is that our local workers in Malawi, they walk around the planting polygons, or they walk around the planting site and with a GPS phone, and they record a planting polygon basically, and then they send this via messenger to us, and then we put it into the UGCS mapper software. In here you can basically create a drone flight path. So what you see here is like maybe the drone would start here, go up in the air, and then fly the zigzag pattern, and then after that you would have a photo of the ground each 4 to 5 meters. And then we use the Pix4D mapper basically to show all the different or to combine all those photos into a map. Here you have an overview of all the individual photos that have been taken. Each red dot represents one photo. So this is an area that Ecosia has been supporting us and has supporting the community in Enyazini for planting indigenous trees mainly, or only actually. And so this is the drone mapping that we're using, and as it is quite tricky in the beginning to really show, hey, we did not only have people dig planting holes but also plant seedlings, we also have staff walking around on the ground taking photos. These are then projected on the map like this, and now you can basically just click on any photo and you see the different seedlings on this map. And like this, it should definitely be possible to just observe the change without even using artificial intelligence software or modern detection, but you should just be able to see that in areas that are completely barren like here, that there should be more plants coming. And the great thing is, if you have so many different positions from where the photo has been taken, what you can do is, so let me show you this in the Pix4D mapper. Here on top you can see one individual photo, and then you have this amazing 3D model. And the great thing is, you can just observe it in 3D, and you can look around, you can zoom around, and you can also do measurements. For example, like this, you see the actual erosion channels. You can measure the depth, you can measure the volume of the soil that has been removed, and you can obviously then compare this from year to year. So this is what we're trying to do to show the actual impact that tree planting has.
So there you go. The reason we don't publish a before and after picture every day is because we take some time to draw conclusions from the images we receive, so we don't make tree planting look like something too simple. And now, because I promised you, but also because you stuck with me through this entire episode, here are the latest before and after images of your trees. Now, you can even read the satellite images in there too.